Getting started with Ultivar Machine ATV-320. Hello, today we will guide you through the installation, wiring, and commissioning of your ATV-320. The ATV-320 is available in compact or book format for integration in a variety of different cabinet types. Unpacking the drive and getting product information. Unpack the drive and verify that it has not been damaged. Scan the QR code on the front of the drive to get your product information, technical documentation, and error codes explanations. Verify that the mains voltage value is compatible with the product. Mounting. In this video, we will use the compact form factor drive reference ATV-320U22M2C. The product has to be mounted vertically as shown in the Getting Started, along with other mechanical and environmental constraints. The drive is designed to be used in a controlled indoor environment. Tighten the two fixation screws in each corner of your product. There are three types of drive mounting. Type A, for temperatures up to 50 degrees Celsius. Type B, for temperatures up to 50 degrees Celsius. Type C, for temperatures between 50 degrees Celsius and 60 degrees Celsius. The vent cover should be removed for operation at surrounding air temperature above 50 degrees Celsius, 122 degrees Fahrenheit, and when the drives are mounted side by side. Depending on the switching frequency, additional derating may be required. Refer to the derating curves in the installation manual. For more information, refer to the ATV-320 installation manual. Wiring. For the power part, we will follow this diagram. KM1, line contactor. T1, transformer. Q2, circuit breaker, protection for the primary of the transformer. Q3, circuit breaker, protection for the secondary of the transformer. To improve electromagnetic compatibility, we use the EMC plate supplied with the product to attach the cable shields to the plate. Refer to the Ultivar Machine ATV-320 catalog to check if the product you purchased includes an EMC plate. To access the control terminal blocks, open the cover. To access the power supply terminals, push the locking tab using a screwdriver. Remove the wiring cover. Then tilt and remove the terminal cover. Start by wiring the ground cables. Then the motor cables. Use shielded cables to connect the motor to the drive. And finally, wire the power supply part. For tightening torques, refer to the product nameplate or the ATV-320 installation manual. Verify that the switch is on default position SRC mode. For the control part, we will follow this diagram. 1. Analog output. 2. Analog inputs. 3. Potentiometer SZ1RV1202, 2.2 kiloohms or similar, 10 kiloohms maximum. 4. Digital inputs. Perform the same operation with the potentiometer for reference frequency and the digital inputs for terminal commands. Make sure that you connect the ground cable to the PE terminal. If you are not using an EMC plate on ATV-320 compact form or ATV-320 IP65 and IP66 drives, wire the PE terminal as shown here. Example for frame size 3C. Use shielded cables for analogic and digital parts and keep them separate. Keep the power and the control cables separate to improve the electromagnetic compatibility. Once the wiring is done, close the cover. Before switching on, use the checklist available on the ATV-320 installation manual. NVE-41289. Start with the mechanical part installation. Continue by checking the electrical installation. Finish by checking the covers and seals. Commissioning. Before you start the configuration, ensure that the digital inputs used are not active. Apply power to the drive. Go to Configuration menu. Full. Then simply Start menu. Set the following parameters according to your motor nameplate. In our case, we will use the nameplate displayed on the top left corner. Motor Standard. Nominal motor power. Nominal motor voltage. Nominal motor current. Nominal motor frequency. Nominal motor speed. Motor TH current. Then verify that 2/3 wire control equals 2 wire control. Once all these parameters are set, you must do an auto-tuning procedure, allowing the drive to refine the motor characteristics. Go to Auto-Tuning, then Apply Auto-Tuning, and keep pressing the button until you hear a motor noise, which is totally normal. To check if auto-tuning has been done correctly, check the Auto-Tuning status, and you should find the status Auto-Tuning Done. Or check the Tune selection, and you should find the status Measure. If you switch off the drive, switch it on again, and check that auto-tuning has been performed, you should see the menu Tune selection, and you should find the status Measure. If you change the value of one or more parameters after performing auto-tuning, the value of auto-tuning status is reset to not done, and you must perform auto-tuning again. Configuring an application. The last operation to perform is setting the drive according to the application requirements. In this example, an acceleration time of 3 seconds, a deceleration time of 3 seconds. A low speed, LSP, limited to 0 Hz. And a high speed, limited to 50 Hz. You can now start your motor. Switch on DI1 forward or DI2 reverse. Use the potentiometer on AI1 to set the reference frequency. Troubleshooting. To access troubleshooting, you can scan the QR code on the front of the drive to get error codes explanations. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website.